Hey guys, I'm LB, and last time on Portal Stories Mel, we played the game, then we broke the game, and now we're going to go into advanced mode. This is the original mod with harder puzzles. Now, in all honesty, I probably should have done this first, but I didn't even know what this was, really. I just jumped into story mode because I knew that's how you would start the game. So, yeah, this looks like what we were intended to play, and this will probably explain why there's a whole bunch of weird missing or extra puzzle elements and stuff. So hopefully, this will give us a better view of the game. So, let's get started. I'm thinking that this will probably start with the same introduction sequence, so I'll just, you know, wait through that again, but, you know, I just want to see if anything's different. Actual loading screens? Really? Wow.
This thing on? Yeah, okay.
Greetings, astronaut, war hero, or Olympian. My name's Cave Johnson, and boy, do I have something to show you. You're here because you're the best the world has to offer. I don't say that lightly, mind you, so take that as one of the biggest compliments you'll ever get in your life, even if you don't know who I am. In the beginning, I started a shower curtain company, making asbestos-laden shower curtains for the military. But I kept dreaming bigger and better. And you know what? That dreaming became doing. Lots of doing. Which brought you here. You're riding into the little Michigan town of... Wait. Where are we again? Okay, so. This town doesn't have a name yet, as we're the ones who built it, but that doesn't matter. Point is, you're riding there, and you'll soon be at Aperture Science Innovators. We're still getting some of this stuff together, but there's a lot of science we can do in the meantime. You've been selected from a large group of candidates for a special test in our temporary testing areas. When the train arrives at the station, head into the town and into the Aperture building. Don't worry, you'll know where it is. You'll get some more pre-recorded messages once you're there. Now, get ready to do some science. For now, though, we're gonna put on some nice music for you. Enjoy the ride.
That was Loki trying to tell me something and then he realized I was recording and said sorry. It's okay, Loki, I forgive you. It's my fault for not going off a line on Steam Friends when I record. I always forget to do that. So far, this introduction's looking the same, but that's what I would expect.
Alright, you're now arriving at Aperture Central Station. Wait. Chris, get over here. How do you spell station? Okay, think about that for a second. Okay. Does station have an extra O before the I? Alright, listen to me. Back your things. Because you're fired! Get out of my office! Out. Yeah, out. Out of my office. I can't re-record this.
Why can't he re-record it? So, as usual, my same complaint holds that it just seems like Cave Johnson is just a bag of memes, the way they've written him right now. And some people might be okay with that, but I just kinda think it's kinda lame or cheesy or whatever. I like how we actually have loading screens now instead of just black screens. I wonder if that was a bug when I was playing before, because this is actually nice to have actual loading screens.
Now, as I said before, there's a lot we're still working on. Just watch your step on the way out, and as a reminder, Aperture Science Innovators is not responsible for any injury you sustain. Up to and including death by exposure to cosmic ray spallation. Don't worry though. We haven't had an accident like that in 3 days. Sorry. Make that 3 minutes. Here at Aperture Science Innovators, we love to give back to the community. So, Instead of just giving back, we made our own community, entirely made out of Aperture Science malleable concrete on top of the salt mines. And that's exactly why you shouldn't touch the walls or stomp your feet either. Last thing we need is to touch up a dent in the wall because someone was too hands-on.
So, apparently I found out there's an achievement for all those doors that you can press the button on and such. But, I'm not too worried about that achievement. That's one of those things that's here. Collect every one of these things throughout the game that is completely optional. And, I'll do that at some point, but I won't do it on camera because that's kind of boring.
I told you it was easy to find. You found it faster than, any test subjects on record. that's not good. Just head through the door on the right to the elevator. You'll know where to go. So, at first, I wanted to put in a long flight of stairs that spiraled down through the old salt mines down here. Give the test subjects a great view of the place. But no! The zoning boards on my bean counter said that's why they invented elevators. So, when someone in a wheelchair threatened to sue, my former boys chickened out of me and built this elevator to go to our temporary offices. I'm still working on those stairs, and those guys are working on getting new jobs. Seriously though, the stairs aren't ready, so get on that stupid elevator.
Now, I have noticed a lot of people don't like how long this game's intro sequence is, and I can kind of agree, it does kind of go on and on, but, you know, they wanted to show off their cool modding skills, you know? Their cool map-making skills. Because the maps in this game are really awesome.
We're always trying to push the boundaries of science that little bit more. That's why we're taking on this new project. When the bean counters told me not to buy a salt mine with all this science, the first thing they said was, "No, there's too much space! You can't suspend something over nothing and pray that a test could happen in thin air." Well, thanks to some use of the old calculator between years and a generous helping of the "You're Fired" stamp, I came up with a final solution to that. If you can't anchor something in thin air, why bother trying to make it in the air in the first place? I came up with this. Introducing the Aperture Science Innovators Suspended Testing Sphere. Each sphere is suspended in the air, anchored to the walls by concrete and steel lattice rebar. They seem like they float in the air, but in fact, they don't. Plus, we can keep building above them, onward and upward. This salt mine here can take at least 10 of these bad boys per shaft. 9 shafts, 90 tests. We can test whatever we want to, and beat that other company into the ground. Black Mesa. Those guys can kiss my... Anyway, the bean counters cried like babies when they saw the cost of these things, but they wet their pants when I threw them out the door. I pay the bills, I make the decisions around here, and I hire and fire as I please. Now, the first of these spheres won't be ready for a few more months, so you'll be participating in one of our smaller tests, the Aperture Science Innovators Short-Term Relaxation Vault.
Oh, I bet the propulsion gel will actually have a use now in advanced mode. But it's a bit more complicated than just being a fling puzzle. I wonder if those are the stairs that we climb.
I'll tell you a bit more. This test should be real easy for you, though. Just get inside one of the Aperture Science Innovator's short-term relaxation vaults and lie in a bed. You'll feel yourself fall asleep quickly. Don't worry, though. Our science boys will get you out shortly. You'll only be out for a few minutes. An hour, at most, if something goes wrong. Don't worry. We've got everything under control. You'll be making science, and you won't have to do a thing. Who's the winner here? You are.
Whenever they say, "you are," it reminds me of Wheatley. Look at this load screen. I don't know why this didn't happen when I played story mode.
So, as I said on the last pre-recorded message, you'll be heading into an Aperture Science Innovator's short-term relaxation vault for a quick, deep sleep. And then you're done. That's why we brought you here at night. You're most likely a walking zombie. That'll give us the best results. But just remember, don't sleep too long. This isn't a bed and breakfast. And if you decide to stay the night, I'm charging you rent for the next year. We'll have a bed ready for you. Just follow the testing area signs and go to bed. Don't mind the turrets. They're firing blanks. At least that's what Crazy Harry told me. Had six signs, boys, disappeared because of him. Don't worry, those turrets won't kill you. The safety on their guns is on. Had some lab boys shut them down. Crazy Harry lied to me.
Quantum tunneling device. It looks like it's got a weird backpack on it. Ran into a wall while I was sneezing.
If you're hearing this message, you're at the sleeping chamber. Carolyn, is the test ready?
Yes, sir, Mr. Johnson.
Then you're good to go. Step into the chamber and get into the bed. Our lab boys will take care of the rest.
Sweet dreams, Mel. I wonder if this intro sequence with Virgil will be any different, like if it'll be more difficult to get where we need to go. I think the conversion gels, the propulsion gel is the only thing we need to worry about. Ethan did say that the game was much harder when he played it, as he remembers it, so probably he played advanced mode.
Is this thing on? Hello? Hello? Can you hear me? Oh, right, you can't answer. I'm so sorry, astronaut, Olympian, or war hero. There was a slight problem with the test. Don't worry though, we got shot okay. Nothing's different, nothing's changed. Just head out of the chamber, I'll tell you a bit more out there. Don't worry about the heights. Had a few of my scientists make what's called long fall boots. I mean, Aperture Science Innovators long fall boots.
I didn't know I could get up here.
No, easier to think of than I thought. Pick that yellow device up. Don't worry, it's not hazardous. I've had the scientists leave you a new device to help.
I'm gonna try and keep my eye on this turret this time, because last time we lost it somehow.
Don't worry though, we built the building like this. Don't worry about that. It's just, a new drilling test we're doing down below. Yeah, to get the salt mines deeper, to get more testing spirits in. Yeah, that's it. Just ignore that.
I really don't know how this guy disappeared last time. Like, he was literally there one moment and then gone the next, so I don't know what happened to him. So this time, we're gonna try and keep him with us.
Earthquakes! Lots of earthquakes. Yeah, you get lots of those here in Michigan. These earthquakes even shook up time a bit. Some stuff from the future got here. Yeah. That's how it's here. Don't worry, it's still 1952. Adlai Stevenson is still president.
So there is no portal surface here, so we can't fling ourselves this time.
The earthquakes kind of did some redecorating in here. Destroy the door too. You'll have to find another way out.
Let's see, where do we want this propulsion gel to go? So here's where we have to fling ourselves out of, but the question is, where is our run-up?
There's gotta be something you can use to launch yourself over the door. There has to be another way out.
Where'd the button go? Oh, it's right here. Okay, where do we want to launch ourselves from? Oops, come on. Can we go this way at all? Nope, doesn't look like it. Are there other portal surfaces in here at all? Ah, yes, there are. Okay, let's put this guy here. There we go. So now, oops, don't do that. Come with me. We need to shoot that. And then we can do this. The glass broke. I don't think that happened to me last time.
Things might look different than what you're used to, but while you were spending that little time sleeping, we had some aperture science nanomachines come in and build all this stuff. Yeah, that's it. They're quick little guys, faster than any science guy I got.
Oops.
Now, I just want to make sure you know something before you go any further. We have these new inventions called... If you turn the power off, you can easily turn it back on. That switch isn't like the rest of them. The others trip a circuit breaker that caused... I think these switches were designed for two people. Maybe your, new test can help. Remember, you can always turn the power on or off again.
There we go. After I played this game, I watched a speedrun, and there's some pretty cool exploits, but... yeah, the main thing that they do is just bunny hop the whole way, and I'm not good at bunny hopping. Haven't even practiced, really. I like how this is turned off while the door's opening, that's kind of... creepy, like you could stand there and get disintegrated as soon as it opens. There we go. Onward. Let's see how things are different. So far, I was right about the propulsion gel. Is it all coming back to you, Ethan? Are you starting to remember?
Oh, that's meant to happen. Just to test your, reflexes. You know, after your short sleep.
Onward and upward. Yep, the loading screens are working now. I don't know why they weren't working for story mode. I guess it's because they were the easier levels, and I don't know. Why would they do that, though? Why not just give us the hard levels right from the get-go?
Bravo Volta, the...
Aha!
Hold on.
There is an Emancipation Grill here that was not here before.
You'll need a portal device to get through. Sorry, I meant a portable quantum tunneling device. Look! It's in your hands right now! The scientists did their job. You'll do fine.
There's one here that was not here before. Is this temporary? Yeah, it is temporary. Interesting. watching somebody play on a live stream, actually. I got them to play the game after they played Portal 2. And that cube kept falling off the edge of them whenever they respawned it, so that's kind of weird. So yeah, these emancipation grills are new. I wonder if we'll actually have a use for this area finally then. Yeah, because we won't be able to go through here anymore, so we'll definitely have to turn this off now. That's still permanent, good. Well, actually no, I wanna do... There we go. And then, we want to go... over there. Here we go. Let's move this guy over here, because that's where we're gonna want him. We gotta go over here. And solve this test the same way as before now. Pretty much the same test now, except that there's actually a point for that button to exist. Oops, come on. Here we go. I wonder if this one's gonna be harder at all. Oop, come on, stay on the butt. Stay on the button.
Now everything about this test is lead-lined, according to my 1950s notes here in my 1950s filing cabinet. It says it's harmful to humans. Not harmful to humans. You'll be okay. Perfectly fine. Nothing to worry about. Oh, and don't worry about the boxes. We got a ton backstocked ready for this kind of thing. Thrown at the wall, destroyed, rinse and repeat. Useless little things. Made them in an hour.
Yep, this one's the same test.
You're not dead. That means that high toxicity lead didn't get in the air and, great job, astronaut, Olympian, or war hero. You really are a merit to science. Or something like that. Just remember the Nuremberg Olympics.
And by the way, these are gonna be half-hour episodes, as you can probably tell. Because, you know, we've already played the game. And I wanna get through it quickly this time. But, it's also gonna be advanced, so yeah.
Now see, this test uses
okay,
the
how is this guy gonna be different?
Innovators propulsion gel. It allows you to... No, wait, hold on. This record says they didn't make that until the 70s. Never you mind that. Just, solve science.
Aha! They fixed it! They fixed it. I really do wonder why they added exploits to make them easier rather than just, I don't know. It just seems odd the way they made it easier. Okay. Let's get this cube out of here. Oops, come on. There we go. I'll just put the cube for there now. I mean, there for now. For there now. What am I saying? Okay, where do we want to go? I think we just do the gotta do it the proper way now, that's good. Let me get up there so I can actually shoot this. There we go. Now we just go back. And we do this the proper way. Oh no, that's bad. Okay, let me just get into a cube real quick. thank you. And, I'll just do it this way. There we go. So now, all we have to do is that, and we are good to go. Yep, that's the intended way to do that puzzle for sure. I don't know why they made it easy to exploit on story mode.
Alright, oh, hold on a second, Mel. I don't think you're that stupid that you're going to fall for this anymore. I'll be blunt now. I'm not Cave Johnson. This is-
Wait, you're not? Shocker.
Everyone you knew and loved is dead. And now you're stuck here, in Aperture Science, down with the trash. Like me. After everyone left because of that boat.
This is still broken!
We already knew, but, whatever. However, I can get us out of here. If you're willing to let a voice in the sky, who just told you he was lying the entire time he was talking to you, control nearly every movement you make. Is that okay? I'll just take your silence as a yes. Oh, right, you can't answer me. Just do what I say, and you'll be fine. Okay?
It's still broken, guys. They didn't fix it in advance like I was hoping they would. So yeah, what you're supposed to do is, as I showed in that video, you're supposed to get the gel on here and bounce the cube in here like I did in my initial playthrough, but... Nope, we're not doing that. If it's still broken in advanced mode, I'm gonna use the broken method just to show you guys how it's broken. Okay, that's right, we needed to do something like this. Okay, let's get a new cube real quick. Let's see, I'll put the cube here. And I need to get back up there. There we go. That's how you break this test. Okay, how is this one gonna be broken?
Before.
Actually, I don't think this one was broken at all when we played it initially.
Right. I'd rather not have my one chance of escape have a panic attack and die on me after years of being suspended in a faulty relaxation vault. Which could be a real possibility, because as my records show, the old test could cause heart attacks after small exposures to the chemicals. And you were pumped full of them! So, let's all just take a breath and start over. My name's Virgil. I'm a core from up in
the
Richmond
Center.
Where did
the button for this go?
And before you even think of asking, yes, there is a building above you, and yes, I came from it. I'm not crazy. Don't be too alarmed, though. A lot's changed since you got put on ice.
Wasn't there a button to turn this on? What? I forgot how to turn this on. Oh well, let's just sling ourselves over there. That's how we did it before, right? And we can just swing ourselves up there. Maybe we don't even need that for this test in advanced mode. Or maybe the button to turn it on's in here? Hmm. Yeah, that turns this on. How do they want us to get the cube, though, is the question. Oh, duh. I'm an idiot. Interesting. How do they want us to get the height for this? Oh, duh, I know. I know what we have to do. It's pretty simple. Oh, nope. Let me back in. Okay, now we just sling ourselves. So yeah, no gel required for this one.
Good job, Mel. See that pipe there? That the repulsion gel's leaking on? That'll take you to the pumping station. Jump down and walk on it. Oh, and try not to fall off. That goo down there is corrosive, and it doesn't like human skin.
That's actually cool that that test, doesn't require the gel at all. Well, guys, that's it for this episode, and I will see you in the next one.
Shooting range at the far side of the room. If you can get through there, you should be able to get to the fourth testing track. That'll take you up to where I am.